says Marcus is on.
I'm here.
Yeah, buddies. Yeah, motherfuckers. Yeah, lizard people and their people on the random side of the motherfucking planet. This is Wolfman Mike coming through to you. Yes, yes, yes. This is Paranormal Motherfucking Radio. Hashtag in your headlines. Yeah, baby, I got Jeff.
Oh no. What the hell's going on here?
Hell yeah! We got Darren. What is Darren?
Hey, Wolfman. Sounds great.
Man, I'm over here getting trapped by dragons. I don't know, man. I thought I was in a Disney. I was reading my some Disney stuff. Oh yeah, it is a Disney movie. The dragons.
Yes, sir. How you doing? How are you?
Hey, oh, pretty good.
I'm coming
you?
To you, and I am the Wolfman.
Oh, I thought I was the Wolfman.
We believe in the wolf. Rawr, rawr. Fantastic. Oh, all right, let's find out what's happening.
Fantastic,
hello,
baby, yeah.
I am the Wolfman.
No, I am the Wolfman.
What's that you want to hear? Jumping Jack Flash? Well, that's a real oldie goldie. Okay, babe, you got it. Right, all right, bye-bye.
Ooh,
okay,
hello.
Time.
Oh, I love this time.
The time
yeah.
will be. What? Banner. 14/30/11/12 o'clock. All right, on your dial. EECH coming through. The Dracola Company, owned by the Count, if you can believe that.
My God, this cat is dying.
Monster Castle, yeah, baby. Oh.
Well, Welcome to the Monster Castle Paranormal Radio. And I am your host, Igor. And Wolfman Mike will be coming on shortly.
Yeah, I'm here, man.
But for now,
Igor,
I would like to torture one of my subjects.
Yeah.
With,
Igor,
I think, what?
I think I want to spin some vinyl.
That was amazing. The castle is full of monsters tonight.
Bunch of freaks. I hear something a little funny over there.
Wolfman Mike is gonna visit you in your sleep.
I feel all funny inside. I'm tingly.
Yes, he wants to make you fuzzy. He wants to see that fuzzy.
Oh, shit
is right. He's going to sneak in your window, and then he's going to steal that dildo of your wife, girlfriend, or your boyfriend, whoever it is that has that dildo in the top dresser drawer. Oh, Jeffy, he's going to come for you tonight. Wolfman, motherfucker. You better hide your children and lock up your husbands, because Wolfman Mike is raping motherfuckers out here. Hey, Dad, he'll suck your dick, too. Don't get jealous, because I'm only talking to Jeff right now.
I'm here.
Hey!
Tell us a story.
Yeah!
Tell us a story, Wolfman.
Yeah, Wolfman Mike back in this bitch. That was a long intro. I fucking thought I was talking earlier, but I wasn't. Yeah. What's going on, man? It's Wolfman, my motherfucking Mike Radio, Paranormal Radio. We gonna do some tarot card readings earlier, like I said, tarot. You heard me, didn't you, Darren?
Yes.
Yes, you heard me when I said tarot. Right,
let's do
Jeff?
Tarot cards.
Tarot,
yeah, like, man. We're here. I'm Wolfman Mike, man. I'm two carton of cigarettes away from having a throat hole. Having a throat hole microphone. Yeah. Wait till I have a throat hole microphone, then I'll really be Wolfman Mike in this match. Hell yeah, two cartons. So, yeah. I was just kidding earlier, Jeff, when I was talking about I was going to sneak in your window.
Oh, really? I'm kind of disappointed now.
Wow.
That's some good stuff there.
Wow. Yeah, I mean, you do believe in aliens, don't ya?
Yeah. Just like you, Wolfman. Tell us a story, Wolfman.
Yeah, Wolfman Mike's Radio believes in fucking anal probes from aliens and stuff.
Bet so, you got a tiny little probe, huh?
Man, yeah. I got the littlest fucking probe. I'm probing cats. It doesn't matter. Gerbils, I can fit it in there.
Hunk like a hamster, are you?
Yeah, you know, not like Richard Gere where he can fit hamsters in him. Wow. Don't you guys remember that rumor when we were kids?
Before it's not a rumor, it's a true story.
There we go. Yeah, you remember it. I'm definitely sneaking in your bedroom tonight. This is Wolfman Mike. I'll be broadcasting live from Jeff's anus later tonight.
Wolfman, tell us about your tiny probe.
Man, it's so tiny. Goddamn, one time I pulled it out, and nobody even realized I pulled it out. Shit, I'm so embarrassed. This is Wolfman Mike broadcasting to you live. My little penis probe.
Yes,
you damn right, sir.
Poor Wolfman.
Hell yeah, man. Wolfman Mike back in this bitch, man. I'm loose. I'm feeling good, man. How the fuck you guys feeling? How's your wiener there, Darren?
It's doing well.
Hell yeah. Hanging. Little what? Left to the right or too little? Are you a little guy? You a little guy like Wolfman Mike? How big is your probe, Aaron?
It's average. It's not tiny like Wolfman's.
Hell, hey man, good look for you. I had cameras in your house for like the last 4 years, so I've seen it plenty of times.
Yeah, so you could see it at least.
I'm like Big Brother, man. I'm looking out for my brothers. You know what I'm saying? Make sure their wieners are good, right, Jeff?
Oh, yeah. keeping it wet.
Oh, God.
Wolfman, are you back yet? Goddamn, my voice is fucked up. I'm trying to talk like this. Goddamn, Wolfman. Come on, Wolfman. We need some tarot card readings.
I'm here.
Here we go, Boo Boo.
I'm here.
Yeah, man. Sorry, talk about your little probe and stuff, but I didn't listen. They egged me on.
They threw eggs at you, through Skype.
They bullied
him
me.
His little eggs.
It was a Skype swipe, egging. Oh yeah, Amy, we're gonna do dirty tarot card readings.
Sweet.
She's Amy's back in our chat room.
Good.
Yep.
Oh. Hell yeah.
Gotta get her to call in. We'll do a tarot card reading for her. You could do it.
Okay. If she has to call the number then. She'll have to call 775-990-8447.
Say it again.
Yeah, we should just put it on the speaker chat.
I'll just write it up here.
Put it on the speaker.
Put
it in mine.
I got it. You want me to do it? I got it.
775.
I got to set it up so that when she calls, it'll come on.
Hey, or else call 920-455-5239. Once again, that's 920-455-5239. 455-5239. With a 920 in the front.
She's gonna call in.
Good.
Yeah, call that number, man. I'll answer.
She doesn't know what she's gonna look forward to there with the tarot card reading. She was here last weekend, maybe.
What the hell is that?
Got the ghost box on?
Casper. No, I don't know what's going on.
At least Dave, it's not the cam girl. Like, hey, like the cam girl advertisement that comes up.
Shut up. When,
like X videos and shit. All of a sudden, he's like, I didn't think I had this still up.
Yeah.
Hey,
sounds like an ass blaster.
Okay.
You want to get your ass blasted? Hey. Just go.
Now I'm wearing my ass hat.
Hell yeah, I got my ass hat on. My name is Monica. I believe in aliens.
Is it ass hat? Is that something when you take your underwear off and put it on your head?
Yes, it is!
Ah, yes.
Well, now she's asking about the other number. So what is that? On your end, that would be on Yuck's end. So
yeah.
Then you'd probably be able to hear everybody. If you call the number, then you only hear me. Well, actually, they'll be able to all hear you, but only I'll be able to talk to you. So, yeah, I don't have it unless I get another computer going in. I got.
Yeah, call my number,
920-455-5239.
That's right, bitch, 5239.
5239 Okay. So, I think it's about time for some rock and roll with a little bit personal style rock and roll. Yeah.
So how long did you want to hang up before ago? I mean, Darren?
Till 6 in the morning.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yo. Same dog. Same wrong gin and juice.
Maybe not. Okay. That was terrible.
Hey, you, hey, you strum a chord and I'll sing after it.
Okay,
and I'll
here
just
we go.
Make up some more chords. I sing when you're still strumming, everything will be off because it's echoing, not on tempo. So if you just strum a fucking chord,
and you can tell
chord,
them to go
smoking a cigarette with a playing guitar just like Keith Richards, man. Fuck yeah.
That was working good. Hey, Wolfman. Are you the one...
What's that?
Are you the one playing the guitar?
Yeah.
Keep a rhythm going and let Yuck sing. That was working good. He's on a roll there.
It will be off tempo, though.
There's a delay on Skype, so it's. I don't know how that's gonna mix.
If you just play a chord like dun dun dun, let it play. I can fucking sing after it.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Oh yeah, fucking. Oh no, yeah. Call in to 920-455-239. I'll find the key every time you play. Fucking A. Yeah. Darren.
Yeah, my name is Wolfman Mike. My probe is little. Yes, little fuck. I told you how small it is. Yes, little. Yes, little. Little, little, little.
Tall.
Don't touch me there. I don't like it when you touch me there. Oh, hello. Hello, is Amy there? Is that Amy? Somebody's calling here. Should be able to hear her. Hello?
We can't fucking hear her.
Okay.
When I'm talking about Wolfman Mike's probe, I'm talking about his penis.
There's a lot of clinking and cranking going on there.
Yeah, okay. Uh-oh. That's so awesome.
Not much to talk about.
Oh, my God.
She tried calling.
Very little.
She must have tried calling
I don't know. It answered.
Hey, I got three people in the corner chat room. Hey, Joel the Mole, Russell Zavala, and T-Place 31, man. Thanks for hanging out with us right now. If you guys want to call in and get your card reading, a tarot card reading, call me right now. Hell yeah, man. Wolfman Mike will read you your fortune forecast.
Oh, she said she couldn't hear me. Yeah, because the...
Russell, call me. Call me, Skype in on my number. Get in the corner. You can Skype me or get in the corner at T-Place. You know the fuck to do. Joel the Mole, come on, man. Wolfman Mike is here.
Okay, well, hang on. Maybe,
you think you got a chance with this girl? Huh? You think you bought the lucky motherfucking lottery ticket, huh? Come on, man. He's going to tell you, right? Right, Wolfman?
How could Jake Dog do it then?
What?
He called in and he could hear me.
Man, this motherfucker. I just set him up. He's like, da, 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 da. Even before anybody... Wait a minute. Hey, brother. Before anybody called you, you said... Don't call me because all you'll be able to hear is me. So why are you surprised your shit's fucking up?
Well, when Jake Doug called me, he could hear me.
Hello?
Oh,
okay. Hey, I can hear you.
Okay, yeah, I got to talk more like at the phone. So I'll put my microphone like this. Yeah. Now, how's that?
Yeah, fine. I can only hear you, actually.
Yeah, you will only be able to hear me. You could only hear me. That's right.
That's okay.
Okay.
But they can hear you.
Tell her to call in on my number.
That sucks.
Exactly. It's because I don't have another computer hooked up. I'm just using my phone.
Okay.
Because it doesn't have an input for a microphone input. Well,
hey, Wolfman.
I don't have an adapter for it. I don't know. Can you get those?
He's trying to share her.
Well, what I use with my show, I have multiple devices. I use three devices. I have the broadcast desktop. I have the laptop I use for the guest Skype who's calling in. And then I have just like an iPad or an iPhone or something set up for other people to call in.
And how do you input into that iPad?
Skype. Oh, I use an iRig, which actually went out on me tonight because I didn't have the 9-volt battery that I needed to replace in there. But it's powered by a 9-volt battery. You plug it into the mini jack and an external device like an iPad or just something, anything that'll run Skype. And that's how I use it. And then I run that. Oh, sorry. I run that out, the iRig, because it's XLR input. I run that from the iPad to my board.
I know, right?
I'm sorry. Where did you get the device from? Did you have to order it online?
You can order it online. You can order it on Amazon, or you can get one from Guitar Center, or I don't know what you have up there.
Yeah, I checked at the guitar places up here suck.
Yeah, it's iRig. And, they sell a lot of different iRig devices. This one is the iRig Pre. It's like a microphone preamp thing, but...
Does it turn into an alien?
Basically, I don't
Yuck
use
wants to know if it turns into an alien.
Oh, now he hears us.
Yuck wants to know
he
if...
he fucking hears us.
Yeah. Oh, I can hear you.
She can't hear us.
She can't. I can hear you, but she can't.
Man,
give her Yuck's number.
Yeah, give her Yuck's number. Everybody's screaming for it.
Can you call back on... Yeah, she has your number. 920-455-5239. Did you try that one, Amy?
No, I didn't. I'll try calling back
on that
one.
Yeah, if you call that one, then everyone will be able to hear you. Because we've
got...
Yuck and I have our studios linked.
All right, sounds great.
Okay. And Jake Doug says you have the best voice, Amy. I think Yuck's voice is sexier.
Oh, now
Yuck's on fire tonight.
Now he wants to acknowledge me. Oh, thanks for calling me sexy, boo boo. Hey man, I just hope everything's linked so I can just add her in. See, I can't add her in.
I want to talk to her. I haven't talked to her ever yet.
I can't add her into the call. Hold
Why?
On. Hold on. I'm gonna answer her call, and I'm going to ask her to Skype in. Okay?
Okay.
Or no, Wolfman.
She could Skype into mine, too. It don't matter.
Yeah. All right, here,
if
I'm going to just talk.
If you Skype her in, it'll come on to mine, too.
Okay, hold on.
Yeah. Okay, well, then, in the meantime, we're going to... What do you think?
Play a riff. Jeff will sing
along. Oh, you want me to play a riff?
Yeah.
Oh, man. I was thinking more like, what the hell was I looking for? I was looking for something.
I want to hear Tune the Groove tonight. Can you load that baby up?
Oh, I think I have that on this phone right here. I could put that through right
it's
now.
It's a short song. I love that song.
Tune the Groove. That's the one with no lyrics in it.
That's right.
I want to hear Emily's Father. I want to hear Spooky Song still.
Oh.
I mean, this is a freaky, spooky
song. Well, we could do that tomorrow night.
Yeah, that's true.
Close to Halloween.
Okay, we'll just put Groove Song on. I'll find
some lyrics.
Oh, there we go.
Well, you got some lyrics?
And you can tell them to go themselves.
Oh, being a quiet and mellow night here, just surfing the web a little.
It's not quiet anymore. Not now the yuck's here.
No, it's not quiet anymore. He's talking. I think he was talking about, I don't know, 47 Talk maybe? I don't know. Winding down, just listen to what
I'm hearing the ghosts now.
Scary Halloween Nation. Love you, brother. Good night. That was cool. Oh, Aaron's gone, eh? Aw. Oh, he was cool.
Have you seen my wiener? My wiener. Hey, wiener, where are you?
Hey, guess what?
Have you seen my wiener?
TJ from Deep Talk Radio liked our show.
Oh, awesome.
That's really cool that he liked it. Because he posted on here. Listen to Spookathon by Wolfman Mike 47 via Spreaker.
Awesome.
Yeah, that's cool.
That's awesome.
Yes,
hey,
I got to thank him for that. That is
cool.
Hey,
Other Side of Midnight liked our Facebook page.
Hey.
You're kidding.
Love no. How about that?
That's pretty good, man.
Studley.
Yes.
Are you there, Wolfman?
Yeah, I am, man. I was touching myself a little bit while I was reading that tweet.
Hey. Add her on Skype, man. You can add her to the call, okay? Do you need me to send you her contacts? Add her to the call on
the
Skype.
The way it works, Amy, is if it's for best way on I've found is if you, you add as a friend first or as a contact first, and then it goes into the call really easily.
Exactly. That's exactly what I'm talking about, motherfucker. So I'm going to send you her contacts, okay? Wolfman, I'm sending you her contacts. I'm sending her yours contacts. And then all you got to do is add her like you added me and Jeff and Darren.
Okay.
Okay.
So, where are you sending it through? Skype?
Yeah, on Skype, yes. On Skype. I'm totally only talking about Skype here.
And are you playing with yourself while you're doing that? I am.
Stop so you can focus.
Okay. Okay, thank here you. It is.
God damn, motherfucker.
Amy on the radio sent me. I got it. I got her. She did it herself. I can add her in now. There we go. Now whoa, can't be added.
It's time for some tarot card readings.
What's going on here? I added her in. Oh, here. Why isn't it? That's strange. Wolfman White shared contact details. Add to group call. That always works. Now, why isn't it working this time? That's weird. That's fucking weird, man. Huh. That's never happened before.
Oh, man. It sure has. Just get her back on, do a tarot reading. We'll listen to it.
Yeah, exactly. If this doesn't work, just call her phone. Like you just were. Tell her it didn't work, and we could just listen to you guys. We'll just listen to you.
I'll do it a different way. I'll do it this way. Hang on. Add people to the call.
She was cool when I talked to her. She was like, no problem. I thanked her for dealing with our fucking dumbass problems. So she was really cool.
Amy on the radio. It's showing that she... I don't know. There we go. I got it. I did it a different way and it worked. I know how to do it better than you.
But only fighting with yourself from 2 moments ago. Okay?
Yes, I am. I beat myself.
Yourself from a couple moments ago, asshole.
But I enjoy electrocuting myself just a little bit once in a while.
All
right. Amy, are you there? It shows that she's at it. Hello? Amy?
Oh, look, she dipped. Look, you were banging too fast.
What happened? The doesn't work. It's not working.
You fucked it up, y'all.
It's a fuck. It's stupid, a fuck.
Man, stop fucking up, then.
You guys kill me every night, every Friday night.
Yeah, Amy said try again. Try to add her again.
Okay.
Do it.
I'll try again. I try this a while, about a time for one pizza.
I want some fucking pizza for goddamn sure right now. Pizza sounds good as fuck.
I love pie.
Hair pie. Like revenge.
To try
nurse.
To do it one more time because she's a special.
And
sometimes we do pretend we are actually stunt people in the movies, and we do breakaway bottles on our head, but we use the real bottles.
Hey, can you hear me?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes, we can.
Awesome.
Thank God we can hear you and not him anymore. Not that bad.
So, give me my reason.
Shuffling them cards up, Wolfman.
Coming now for your free reading.
Okay, but first I wanted to do... how do we do
the baptizer?
We do the forceful baptism of the alien creatures. We do forceful baptism. Because we want to get them into the Catholic Church first. So when the aliens are coming down, we'd like to take them and forcefully baptize them. Very good. Stick their fucking head in the water. And some of them don't even survive it. But I you know, the other ones, they are going to join the church.
Amy, if you can turn your volume up or turn your output up a little more so we can hear you a little louder.
How is that?
Perfect.
Perfect.
Okay, let's try something else.
All right, I'm going to do a reading for you.
Shit, all of a sudden we got the fucked up Pope all of a sudden doing the readings tonight.
we got the Catholic priest doing the tarot card reading.
Yes, Father, but that's the thing. You don't really think that I'm a real Catholic priest, do you? I just like the Pope.
I just figured back, because all the little boys are around you.
Actually, I like the Pope. He's a pretty sexy guy.
Oh, so you're not Catholic then?
I just pretend. I work in the observatory, and we see the aliens and stuff, and they're coming down, and the aliens are come down, and then we take them, and then we forcefully baptize them.
Oh, yeah, forcefully baptize him like Wolfman Mike got forcefully baptized. Yeah, I did once.
Now we have to do a reading.
The aliens, they came down and they came up and
the first card that they have chosen is the Seven of Swords. And it shows it shows you taking seven swords and getting away with it. since it, and it's probably a phallic symbol, and it's probably means you got seven black guys behind your boyfriend's back. That's a terrible.
I'm always cracking dick jokes when I'm not on the radio, so I don't buy it.
Yeah. No, I think she's lying. Just keep that card on the table, right? And go to the next one, right, brother?
Yeah.
Okay, that's the first. That means the past, by the way.
The cards don't lie.
That was your past.
Probably, I don't know. I have no idea. That just doesn't make any sense.
Okay.
Completely random.
Sweetheart, the cards don't lie, baby.
Okay, this the present card.
Have you seen my wiener?
Sorry. My bad. That's the WikiLeaks alarm I got going on. Podesta emails. Yeah, just forget about that. Go ahead.
Have an alarm set up for WikiLeaks?
Yeah, man. Podesta emails. I got to know what's going down. 22 just came out.
Oh.
Okay. This one shows a tower burning. And it's the present, so... It's probably
a phallic symbol.
It's another phallic symbol, but it's burning up.
It's on fire.
It's a big, long, big tower. It's burning up. It's somebody else wants to get you in a different place, and they're burning for you. But everyone's falling out of the building, and it's
awful.
You know what? This tower card really reminds me of 911 when I look at it. People falling out of this burning. It's burning from the top. The top of it's busted off, and there's people falling out of the tower.
Two big phallic symbols getting burned on 911, yo.
So this big, huge dude is throwing the other guys out of the way and tossing them down to their deaths just to get at you.
Huh.
Yeah.
The
future card. It's a naked woman pouring water into a pool. It's the star.
Somebody pouring water into a pool?
Yeah, and there's stars probably, all around her head.
That's probably me in the middle of the summer when I go out late at night to dose the pool with chlorine.
It looks more like you're a witch.
I don't want to dose it in the middle of the afternoon.
It looks more like you're doing witchcraft. And you're really high on some drugs. That's why the stars are flying around your head. Since you're really high and you're naked, running through the woods, really high on mushrooms.
This is a very specific card, isn't it?
Yeah, it's the star, yeah. You're probably looking for somebody's star. Being naked and all. Anybody got one to show her? No? Wow.
I don't have any cards. You're the guy.
No, a star is another name for your, your weenie. You didn't know that?
I did not know that.
It is.
What?
A star.
Because
the moon is in the back and the star is in the front.
What? I've never heard that
before. No, it's
the only thing I ever heard of a star was a starfish meant the butthole, fucker. What are you talking about?
Chocolate starfish.
Oh, that's all you think about, yuck. That's why they call you yuck, isn't it?
Sorry, bro. It's an
that was bad. Okay, the next one is the moon. See? It goes together. I told you.
Yeah, you did.
But but there's two chupacabras, and they're joined by a lobster coming out of the water. And they're all staring at the moon.
Is it the lobstrosity?
Yeah, and oh my God, there's two towers again in this one. In the background, wow.
This sounds like Stephen King Dark Tower tarot cards, kind of. But not really.
Some sort of gangbang, maybe then.
Could be.
Two things. I'm sorry, never mind me.
Yeah.
I'm just thinking about how you called me gay. earlier.
No, you're not gay. You're just happy.
Yeah, and you two dicks. I mean, the cards show it, right?
That was last week, wasn't it?
I'm sorry. I'll shut
okay,
up,
I
man.
Think we you should all try to sound as good as Amy.
I love you.
I love you too, brother. But Jake says that she's got the best voice, so I think we should all try to have really nice voice too.
And do I sound like
Amy,
that?
You do.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
No, you don't.
But it's the best I can do. Jake, do I sound as good now?
So is that our future
Jake.
Card?
Hi, Jake. Do I have a good voice too?
No, that was the future card with the chupacabras howling at the moon, and there's a lobster gonna attack them because he didn't like the howling. But and there's those two buildings are ominous. I don't know. And there's a face in the sun above them, and it looks like the sun is sprinkling down. Like and he's got it doesn't look like a happy face. It's I don't know. He's sweating or something. And the sun's too hot. And get me the fuck out of the sun. It's,
what do you think of these tarot card readings?
I don't know.
He's just getting warmed up. He always says better on his second and third readings.
I'm not drunk.
I know. Trust me, I know.
It's hard to do this when I'm sober.
You're right. It is better when you're drunk. Maybe we should always do the tarot card readings after the drunk show.
I should.
That's okay. You're doing okay.
By the time we get halfway through this show, I'll be drunk.
Okay.
I'm going to start drinking right now.
That's what we're talking about, Wolfman.
It's too bad, Yuck, you don't have a deck of cards because you'd be good at this.
No, you are.
Yeah, you're the tarot card master.
Master, please, I want to electrocute more people.
Do mine. Do me, Wolfman.
Okay. You asked for it. Okay, it's the Two of Wands. The Lord of the Manor with riches, fortune, magnificence, dominion, interest in scientific methods. He's holding like a globe in his hand, like, and he's got a big stick in his other hand. So he's like, he's got a stick in one hand and a ball in the other hand. What does that mean?
I think everything's phallic.
Oh yeah, this whole book is.
Everything when it comes to men, sweetheart.
But he's pondering. He's holding
it. It turns out that Freud actually wrote the book.
Probably did. He's holding it very delicately, the one ball. I wonder where the other ball went. So he's like,
that's my pass.
Well, here comes Billy with his back in his hand. He's a one ball man, and he's off to the rodeo. It's a little lip and a little reek. Come on, you fucking up your step in your grave. Get off stage, goddamn goof, you know. Piss me off.
That's my past.
That was your first card, yep. You're one ball man.
Okay.
Ball check.
Yeah, you better check on that. Or maybe it just means you're not pushing hard enough, you know. You really gotta give it.
Well, I used to be very delicate with my ball.
Oh, you had one of those operations so you can't get girls pregnant anymore. I see.
That's true. Well, you know all about me.
Oh, actually, I had one of those operations too. It hurts for a couple of weeks, man.
I didn't like it either.
Wow. All
right. Tell me my present.
Your present is the Five of Wands, and it's strenuous competition. Struggling to attain riches and success, battling life, a change for better in business. But what I see is five guys with big sticks beating each other. So it looks like a male orgy.
Five guys with big sticks. It's all phallic. Every bit of it's phallic.
I'm making it that way.
And a lot of them.
So there aren't any. There's not really.
You'll never get a good card on these
balls involved. These are just your own
dirty mind. Yes.
Yeah, your own addendums. You know what? I give up talking. That's me done. That's
just 3 a.m.
for me.
It's great.
No, it's just
all she sees is dicks. No matter what we.
Oh,
talk.
Wait a minute. His future card is totally different.
It's cock. Okay.
I don't know. His future card is totally different. It's
oh, good.
It's
thank God.
It's high intelligence and romantic dreams. Cock. Love may come to him. Love may come to him from him to the subject of the reading.
Ooh,
he may
that's
also
by this time, if there's no stick and balls, I'd be worried.
No, there's just a cup. He's I think he's getting drunk and he's going for a horsey ride. He's on a horseback.
Or it could be, you know, cup yourself. Something could happen.
Well, he's got a chalice and he's wearing armor and he's on a horse. That means he's a knight. He's the Knight of Cups.
Is there two girls?
Knight of Cups yourself.
He's a bearer of messages. May indicate advances.
Knight of Protection. There you go.
Oh, it's a proposition. Advances and a proposition or an invitation. Oh, I get it. You're going to cheat on your wife. You're trying to lure someone else in there.
Oh.
Never.
Yeah.
Never. Maybe I'm... Oh.
See, no.
Proposition. Maybe
see,
I'll
wait a minute.
Oh, I get it. She doesn't do certain things for you, so you're going to give her gifts to try to get her to do that.
Wolfman is thinking about two fucking dicks again.
No.
Right?
No. There's no dicks in this one. It's me.
Or it could mean roll over in the middle of the night. Uh-huh. Better cover yourself. Watch the knee. Just watch the knee.
Yeah.
Watch. Okay.
Or the elbow.
Wear a jock strap.
What happens under the cap is safe when we're sleeping, baby. I mean, isn't that what the card just said?
I think so.
Okay, I'm going to meet my
Jeff, I think it's your turn.
I think we should, it's already 40, you know what? We're already 46 minutes into this show.
All right, asshole, read me, do me, do
me.
Do my.
Well, we're not going to have any breaks in this show?
Come on, man,
come on. All right.
We're on a roll.
Who am I doing?
Yuck Nasty.
I want to know the future. I want to know what my life is going to, you know, what kind of romantic that my life might fucking go into in the next couple weeks. And, you know, I'm very jittery about it. Oh. You know, I just started to... I just met this person and she's wonderful and I just want to know if it's going to work out.
Well, this picture says that you could either be a boy or a girl. It says right in here, the Page of Swords.
All right, active... this is what we're going to do. Wolfman. As soon as you say the first card, I'm going to hit a sound effect and we'll just make like a fucking, like it's really important. Ready? Here we go.
The Page of Swords. An active, dark-haired, brown-eyed boy or girl. Betokens vigilant scrutiny, spying for either good or evil.
Oh, okay.
But the man, I mean, girl or thing, is holding a big sword. And he's posing like a faggot.
I know.
Okay.
Like a cigarette.
Yeah. And,
of course. I don't know what other fucking kind of thing
it is. Like you're walking on water and you got clouds all around you and you're all la-di-da and you got this big sword in your hand.
See, that makes sense. I dreamt I was Jesus last night I thought I was a woman, Jesus, and I was in a strip club and there was vodka on the floor and I walked on it.
Oh.
Nice.
All right, what's the next card, Wolfman?
The Magician.
Woohoo!
The Magician. Will, mastery, skill, occult wisdom, power, diplomacy. The ability to take power from above and direct it through desire into manifestation. Now this looks like you turned occult on everyone's ass. You got you got the pentacles out. You got the
pentacles.
Yeah, pentagram, like a pentagram on the table. You got a candle in your hand. You got a ceremonial dagger. You got all kinds of herbs and everything on a table. You're doing magic spells, dude.
Yes.
This is his present?
That's
sounds just like him.
How do you know what he does in the dark?
Recording, dude.
You never know what he does at home.
And lots of tentacles. I like anime porn, and there's tentacles, and you know they eat crazy stuff. I mean, that kind of makes sense.
You look kind of like an angel. You got an infinity sign, almost like a halo above your head.
Where'd the angel
And you're
come
wearing
from?
Like white robes.
All right.
And
makes sense.
Yeah.
My mother always said I was a pretty guy.
Yeah. Let's see what the future card holds.
Oh, yeah.
It's the chariot. And the chariot is... it is conquest, success for those engaged in artistic pursuits.
Yes.
Triumph over money, difficulties, ill health, and foes. Advantage for the seeker will result if he resists his lower promptings and his master and animal passions. That's very important, the animal passions. It is a card of those who achieve greatness. May also betoken travel and comfort, but
there's two sphinxes, there's two sphinxes, and you're right behind them.
They're bent right over in front of you. In my reading, everybody had dicks except for me.
No, you got a big stick in your hand, and there's two bent over sphinxes right in front of you, man. I would say
you're the gay guy holding the dick.
I would say sphinxes are definitely in the category of barnyard oddities.
Okay, so everybody else is reading my dicks, but I'm the one that's got my long animals.
Yeah. And so that means we got to play the song called Barnyard Oddities. Next, here we go.
Our motherfucker ain't that sweetie.
What's going on?
Wolfman.
Yeah.
Wolfman.
Ow!
Stop Wolfman.
That. I want to hear another song. That was great when Yuck was singing along.
Oh, wait a minute. I had something here. What the fuck just happened to it?
We definitely every tarot card reading that we do from now on, we have to have this sound effect on there.
Yeah.
Before you say what the card is, well,
we still have Jeff to do.
There it is.
Oh yeah, we Shwing. Need to do it.
Okay,
yeah.
but we're yeah. gonna do because Stupid. Yours had to do with like deformed animals and you're trying to do them from behind. Then it's kind of like reminds me of the old days when I was a farmer with like two-headed chickens and three-eyed billy goats.
Yep.
And so we're going to do a song first called Barnyard Oddities.
Some crazy shit.
Yeah, man.
Chickens and sounds free.
face.
Yeah. Petting zoo of barnyard oddities. Did you like it?
What, was there some extra sounds in there from Jeff?
No, that wasn't me.
That was Yuck and me.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
That was cool. I liked it. Okay, now it's time for Jeff's reading.
Do me.
Yeah. What, are you ready? You gonna
what
pull
voice do you want me to do?
Oh,
let's give me the best
so
one.
Ready. I'm so ready for this.
How about Father Guido does this? Well, just like to tell you, it's Father Guido is going to do your reading.
Hey, oh. Father Guido, it's been a long time, baby.
That's it's a card of what I think is in your past life, you were a woman.
And, absolutely.
And you look, you like to play with the birds, because you got a bird, and you like to go, and you like the bird to go tweet tweet like. And you talk to the bird like that, and you sometimes when it's bad, you smack the fucking thing a little bit. You know.
You mean like what kind of bird? Like a cock or a rooster?
No, it's like a Tweety bird.
Like a
Just a little Tweety bird, you know? And it just hangs around because you feed it, but really it doesn't really like you very much. But it's a hungry. So, you know, it just sticks around, but, you know, it's kind of, you know, for food. But, you know, when you, your solitary enjoyment of good things in life, you get all this money that you steal and stuff from the men. And you got all these magic coins.
Because
you got 9 magic coins.
Yeah, I hide them.
Pentacles.
You know where I hide them, right?
The pentacles, you know. Like, but it's not the devil pentacle. It's the one you turn it the other way, and it's supposed to be like a good one. But we still burn those people, you know, in the church. If it's a good pentacle or a pentagram, it doesn't matter. We burn you anyway. So you got to burn up like a witch in your past life.
And you whacked the little birdie that was there to eat.
My bird whacker?
Burn the bird.
Goddamn you fucking bird whacker. I fucking seen it in my dreams. I knew you were there to cream on that parrot.
Burn the witch.
Hell yeah, you were burned at the stake because you wanted on your plate some fucking parrot pussy. Because you fuck birds, get it?
Hey, man, I fucked a chicken wing one time.
Hell yeah, are you talking? What kind of birds are you talking about? Are you talking about cock? Or other kind of birds?
All right, present.
All right, and the next card is a judgment. And judgment is awakening, a change of position, a renewal, change in the personal consciousness, which is now on the verge of a blending with the universal. And all of these naked kids are down there while you're playing a trumpet for them. And they're all going thinking, "Ah, oh, you're like a god." But
I know that card. That's a very rare card. It only comes out on special occasions with all the naked kids on the bottom of the card.
Yeah, that's the one.
I know.
It's a judgment. It's a very
special. So what
does
that mean for him?
It's a hierarchy card.
Hierarchy for him? I mean, what's going on? Tell us the truth.
This sounds like genuine Catholic tarot.
It looks like a god to come down, and because you got to burn like a witch, he's going to let you have a lot of little naked kids to play with.
It's like heaven.
That is awful.
How does that card to you?
Well, that's like
that
a heaven. The Pope said if there really was a heaven, I would have lots of little naked kids.
Yes, you heard from the cardinal. Yes.
What deck is this that you are using? Who drew these cards?
This is the secret Catholic tarot deck.
Yeah, Illuminati Underground Catholic. Catholics. Children. Little boy. Card deck.
But unfortunately, your last card is a hang the man because you got caught with those kids and they hang you again. And then you didn't get burned this time, but you got hanged.
Oh, shit. That's his future card?
Yeah.
What's oh, you going to hang?
He's going to get hanged.
He got kids. He got the card earlier with all the kids, so now you're going to hang.
Yeah, I got to get hanged then. That's it.
Oh, shit, man. Your life is fucked, brother.
It's a terrible. It's a little bit of fun, but then it's not so fun again after that, you know?
Am I hanging by the neck or by something else?
Upside down. By the foot.
Oh, oh God.
Actually, pinky. The pinky. The pinky toe. Yeah, and the nuts.
They don't really want to tell you how they hang you because it's a really not a very nice.
He doesn't want to worry you.
I can't believe he
actually dealt you the Jared and Subway card. That's a very unique card with all the children on the bottom.
Yeah, kids eat free every day. Foot long, knock at the back door twice.
It's the moon.
Ah, the moon. That's an. It's not a real moon, you know that. That's a fake.
Okay.
I was going to say the moon is falling down. It's going to smack it down on the earth. But then we looked at it another time, and it phased out, and it phased it back in. It's a fake. It's a holographic.
That's what it is. It's holographic.
It's not real.
I know it's not real, but I mean, is it holographic?
It's a covering up for the what is really there. So they have to put a hologram over top of that thing that's there. Which is that giant penis-shaped spacecraft.
Exactly. Like in Star Wars, the Death Star, it was actually supposed to be a penis shape,
yeah, but
they
this
said
is the
just
dick
went
star.
One black ball.
Yeah, but it's shaped like a penis.
I know it is. We educate these motherfuckers.
Is this a flat earth thing? I don't know.
No. Well, when the penis comes down like and smacks on the earth.
Giant. He's like, no.
When that thing smacks on the earth, then it does enough times to smack it down. The earth will be flat after a while of the smacking it down.
Is that what the Pope said?
No, that's I just made that up, really.
Well, yeah, see, he makes up a the what is really good with the arm, you know.
Jeff, that reading sucked.
Yeah.
I feel raped.
That wasn't the best one.
If you're going to feel anyway. Oh, my God.
I like the one.
I was about to say the same thing. If you're going to feel anyway, just feel how I feel.
Well, you know, there was another one with the moon in it, wasn't there? No, it was the sun. So
A-hole Skeptic on Twitter says, if you guys aren't stoned right now, I worry for you.
We are high off of the Holy Spirit. Okay?
The Holy Spirits.
All 15 of them.
I like what he said before that. He said, I have to admit that this is the best tarot reading I've ever heard. But then again, it's the first time for me.
Well, do a reading for him.
Okay. If he's listening, then we'll do him a reading, yeah.
Yeah, do a reading for him.
Dude, like, I should just be your, like, sidekick.
Wait a minute. Who's Peter Lorre? Because it's Billy Van that I was impersonating. I don't know who Peter Lorre is. Have you got a typewriter? Send her a letter. What is this? No matter how vulgar it gets,
that blows my mind.
It's the freaking cards. Yeah, okay. So we're going to do one for A-hole. We're going to do one for you. Here we go.
Hey, Amy, are you still having fun?
Oh, he got the Ace of Wands, man. Oh, you got to do your sound effect.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Hold on. Do, Hey, you know, you should order Viagra or a Cialis. Cialis commercial. Yeah, when you're not feeling half the man should, you should order this Cialis pill. Because that's what's going on when I'm trying to bring up YouTube videos and the fucking ads play. And
this tarot card reading is going to be done in a style with the Wolfman. In really a mellow mood. Yeah. And he's got the Ace of Wands, baby. Yeah, the Ace of Wands. He's holding it. A big, huge wand in his hand. And it's just the hand doesn't belong. It's like a disembodied hand with some clouds behind it. So I think he's imagining that there's a disembodied hand stroking him off real nice and gentle, you know?
Isn't that beautiful?
That's beautiful, man. Yeah. I dig it.
Hell yeah.
Bonjour. Hola, buenos dias.
Hi.
Yo, baby.
Hello.
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 Hi.
Hi. Hello.
Hola.
Hello.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
Why you guys are
yeah.
Doing that, man? Why you, I caramba, man. Why you always gonna do like that, man? Okay, the next card is gonna do it in a Mexican voice. And
okay,
it's,
do this shit, man. Come on, man.
This is the present for you, a whole skeptic. All right.
Yeah.
It's, wait a minute. No, I like this way better. I like this way.
Yeah. It's spiritual power overcomes material power. The triumph of love over hate.
Yeah.
The higher nature over carnal desires. So that means stop touching your kitty cat like that. It's just a kitty cat. It can't help, you know. It can't fight against your powerful thing that you're trying to thrust into it. But it's all right. Just do it gently. Yeah, dig it, man. Dig it. It's the abuse of power, man. Yeah. Yeah. Dig it, man.
Grab him in the pussy.
Sorry.
Is that the past?
That's the present, man. I don't know if he's got a putty tat or not, man. He must have a putty tat. How you like your putty tat, man?
That was a good one. Was that you, Yuck?
Yeah, baby.
That's a good reading there.
No,
was that
was
the past, or are we just waiting to do
No, I was just singing along with him. I was doing his overs. He was like, yeah, and I was like, yeah.
We're not done yet.
Okay.
All right, Wolfman, you got the card pulled up?
Okay, give me the sound.
Here we go. Here's the sound.
Bring the sound.
Here's the motherfucking sound for the finished motherfucking card. This is the present, or I don't know what the fuck it is, but Wolfman knows what the fuck is going on.
Yeah.
And this is for a whole skeptic?
Yeah, this is the future. The future of a whole skeptic is the devil card. Oh, man. Domination.
Damn, I'm jealous.
Over spirit. Sensation divorced from understanding. Illness, bondage to the material. Violence. Revolution, but take it easy, baby. Yeah. Extraordinary effort. Force. Black magic. I know you got this guy. He's got two naked females chained up in front of him, man. He's doing pretty good, man. He's wearing horns. He's got horns. He's really horny. He's got two naked chained up women. And his legs are actually those of a eagle. And he has bat wings.
Bat wings.
Yeah. So he's transformed into a barnyard oddity. Probably he's gonna get some kind of a operation and disfigure himself.
Like, I forgot his name on Twitter. This is your reading, bro.
It looks like.
Yeah, turn the music down a little bit.
Yeah, turn that shit down. Oh, man, baby. Okay.
I'm trying to add him in.
All right, here we go. You got the next card?
No, wait a minute.
Oh, my bad. I'm ready to go. I'm like, let's go to the next one, man. We gotta roll.
Well, just a minute.
Who's joining us?
A-hole.
No way.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Hey, holes in this bitch. Hey, what the fuck is going on with A-hole?
It's doing the same thing. It won't let me join. Maybe too many people on. I don't know.
You gotta get him on this call.
I got you.
I'll dump off.
Hang on a second. I'll try this again. What did you? Oh, he's calling. Add to group call. There we go. Ha ha! A-hole skeptic, yeah. It sounds like he's trying to get in here, man. Hello? Is there anybody in there? I'm trying to get in, but nobody answers the door. And every time I try to get a job, they say, you can't have the job. And they poke me in the forehead. And then we'll get this red dot in the middle of my forehead. And it's very bad, you know.
Fucking hey, if you're gonna get a Slurpee, just don't look at the porno magazines. Just don't look at the porno. Don't pull that film down.
A-hole skeptic, do you know who you're talking to now?
Hello.
Hello, how do you do?
Oh.
You are talking to the variety store at the corner. What would you like?
The mysterious A-hole skeptic on?
You're telling me you guys aren't stoned?
Holy fuck.
We don't stone
people in here. This is not Jerusalem or Afghanistan.
This is the corner store.
Don't call me a racist. Cause I don't know if they stone people, but it's not here.
Just dawning on me how much better this show could be if you were stoned.
I was just going to try to find some of that hash that we make in my country back home, but this is stupid country that Justin Trudeau won't let me have any. But the faggot goes in his own house and always smoke it, but he does not let us, the people, have it anymore.
No, it is breaking up like Heather.
What's that?
Anybody else cutting out?
Entire call, it's everything just distorted and...
fucking Skype.
It's got EDM and motherfucking... Oh, it's a DJ mix on us.
Yeah,
friggin' right. Skype, man.
So, A-hole,
Hello, there's Wolfman Mike again. What's going on, brother? We thought we lost you. We thought you turned short circuit, and Johnny Five is alive all of a sudden on us.
I just heard there was a guy from the corner store was here.
I'm regretting this so much. So much.
Well, just have another drink, man.
You got a sum of my tarot there because I kind of lost track of it.
Oh, it was the last thing it ends up is the devil card, and it shows you having two women, naked women, in chains, and you have horns on your head. So I take that as you being very horny for these two naked women that you have in chains. But it's a good card. I think you got the best card of anyone's. The only thing is that it says that you do black magic in the end, and you use black magic.
I'm pretty sure that's not my card. Real sure.
In my perverse fantasy of reality, it is.
I'm pretty sure I don't want to go there.
I still think this needs to be animated.
How about the Queen of Cups? Would you take that instead?
Ah, sure.
Hold on. What did car did you just mention?
All right, tell us about that, baby.
I would like to hear about the Queen's Cups. Please go ahead.
Okay. Oh, the Queen. This is a woman with light brown hair.
And cups?
And hazel eyes.
And cups?
Yes.
The cups.
She is the beloved good wife and mother. She has the gift of vision, is poetic and imaginative. She dreams, but also acts out her dreams. Like the way she had a sex change.
Yes.
It was very easy. It went very easily for her. The transition was very smooth and loving.
She cut off her dick.
Did you like that one better or no?
Yes.
You know, we should probably stop right there.
You don't want your future? Or was that the future?
That was the future, yeah.
Oh, that was the future.
Yeah.
Well, that's the end anyway, isn't it, right?
So you'll meet this woman. She's great and everything. And you find out that she used to be a man.
Well, nobody's perfect.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Other than that, she's perfect in every way.
Wow, bro. So far, every fucking card you laid out tonight is so perfect on point. You ready for the next one?
No.
I'm not.
Here we go.
Man, it's the Seven of Cups.
Funny.
The seeker has had too many different ideas and desires, all in the realm of imagination. Great dreams, castles in the air. Some attainment, but nothing substantial as of yet. His forces have been scattered. That's me. That's my own reading.
All right.
It's exactly. Actually very accurate, too, because I am a dreamer and I do scatter my attention into lots of different areas.
Especially when you have a lot of people on the fucking air listening to every word you say.
Oh, yeah.
Waiting for you to keep the gimmick going, you just scatter brain right there, bro. I love
but,
you.
But, yeah.
I love you, Wolf.
It's like I'm a bloody scatterbrain.
Oh, yeah, if you just stay in character.
Scatterbrain. Oh, I wasn't supposed to do well, that.
That's really nice.
Yeah, I'm a bloody scatterbrain. That's okay.
I have to say the price was right.
Also, in my vision, some of the things floating around my head are very interesting, floating around me. In one of the cups.
Right now?
Yeah. No, in the card reading, if you look at the card in the pictures... in one of the cups, there's a dragon. In one of them, there's a wreath. One of them has pearls, like, and one of them has a big tower. One has a snake, and one has a person with a, like maybe like a Ku Klux Klan thing over their head, and the other one has, like, just a head, like, that you chopped off or something, you know? Yeah.
I'm so happy.
Happy. That's my next card. It's happy. The Ten of Cups. Happy family life. True friendship. Lasting success. Happiness yet to come. Attainment of the heart's desires. Children dancing. The married couple looking at the sunrise together with their arms outstretched towards the woods. So happy.
Hey, Wolfie?
Yeah.
Back off the mic.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. I do that sometimes. I know it sounds way better when you back off the fucking mic. Yeah.
Back off the fucking mic, dick.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, man. I did it again.
It's okay. My headphones are soaking up the ear blood, so it's okay. Go ahead.
I probably gave you an aneurysm. Oh, here's my last card.
I had to pot you down to like a 2 on my mixer.
Okay. I am?
Yeah. Really loud.
Oh, I didn't realize
that. Get some meters. Get meters. They're good.
Okay. Well, I got a meter right in front of me, but my when I'm trying to read out of a book it's, and your head's down, you can't see.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll hold the book up higher so I can see the meter, too. How's that?
That sounds very pro.
All right. This is the 8 of Pentacles. Wait a minute. I want the thunder sound for this one. Skill in material affairs. Craftsmanship. Skill in handiwork and business. Sometimes merely in the preparatory stage. Employment or commission to come. And it shows a guy making a bunch of those pentacles. So they're probably like some fake magic that, you know, you could sell for a lot of money.
It's a guy making tarot cards.
He's selling fake things to a bunch of idiots and making tons of money. Yeah.
Tarot cards. Well,
say what? Does that happen?
No. That looks like a light. Oh, and there's a castle with a big tower in the background. Ooh, what is that? And it's right behind my ass.
Are you sure there's not two of them?
Yeah. If you're still on me, then it's probably not a
No, phallic. This is me. I'm doing myself.
Oh. Well, ew.
Yeah. I'm doing really myself difficult. Again.
Penis prep!
It's okay. I'll wash it later.
People are very happy that you did this. I know they are. This I'm sure meant a lot to a lot of people, and I'd like to thank everyone for your participation. And I'm sorry, but now I'm gonna have to go kill myself.
Why?
I'm very depressed over my reading. I didn't like the tower behind my ass.
Are you done with the readings?
Yeah, that's it. The tower behind my ass.
Hey, you guys, all right, man, you guys want to goof around for at least another 15 minutes? I got a fun game that we can play.
Okay. Yeah, I'm done with the reading. Let's do something else.
All right, man. You guys know Family Feud, right? We can do what I call is a dumbass feud. I'll be the host. I'll throw out the questions. And let's see if you guys want to play.
With Family Feud. You're not kissing anybody, are you?
Hell no, motherfucker. We don't kiss nobody in this motherfucking family. No.
Unless you dyke out. What? Are you want to play Wolfman or should I just shut up? Your show. Wolfman.
Oh, yeah. I'm here. I just had to get something that sounds like this. Can you guess the thing? Oh, yeah.
A Diet Coke.
Exactly, except I don't have any Diet Coke in it. Just beer.
I may need to get some booze.
Yeah, you do.
I'm back.
I go for a beer run, but we have those laws in my state, so... But if I were in Texas, I think they sell love.
I think it's because I came back. I think I'm screwing everything up. You guys still there?
We are Chinese now, though. We have turned into Chinese people. Sorry about that, but you have gone to the wrong corner. And you order, why you order all the Chinese food and you not pick it up? They have all this shrimp and your egg roll and you not pick it up. Don't cough on all the Chinese food.
Is somebody peeing?
Yes, and then...
No, that comes after.
And then we do the toilet flushing. First the pee, and then the toilet flushing.
Well, that's customary, yeah.
But you forgot to do the flushing. Infinite buffering problems. I am a robot.
Ooh. Okay. So the family game, how does it work?
Where's Yuck?
Yuck! Where are you, man?
Yuck Nasty, hey baby, oh yeah, I'm Yuck Nasty, I'm Nasty, get in the fucking corner, asshole, get in there, stick your head in the corner.
Are we gonna play a game? That's why I called back.
I just hear someone taking a bath or something. Are you guys taking baths together?
Worst game show ever.
Rubber dub dub. Three men in a tub.
What happened to the host of the show, man? I'm going to have to take over the show, aren't I? Okay, guess what this is. Oh, wait a minute.
Lighter?
Oh, wait a minute. It didn't work. No. What the hell? I know it didn't work. That's our next guest.
A slow motion straw?
Godzilla?
Oh, yes, it is. Godzilla, how are you? He's on the show. Also, I have another guest that's coming on.
The dark side of the Force is calling you.
Darth Vader, everyone! Everyone, welcome Mr. Darth Vader! Hey, Darth Vader, how you doing, Darth Vader? Hey, welcome to you. Let's make a dope deal!
Good God.
What have we come along for?
So, let's make a dope deal with Godzilla and Darth Vader. Yeah.
I'm so glad I called. I want to play a game.
All right, a-hole. What is the most paranormal thing that ever happened to you?
I don't really have a good paranormal thing. I got kind of like one or two semi-mysterious but not very interesting things.
Oh.
Like sitting in the house alone one night, and there was this loud banging that sounded like someone was banging on the wall heater or the exhaust pipe of the wall heater. Like really loud, like
Hi,
bang, 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 bang.
People are always asking what our mattress feels like. God. Well, here's how Catherine...
Oh, that was a commercial. I just cut it out.
Well, very nice. So, I don't know. I eventually pulled my pants on and went outside to look around and saw nothing. So, I don't know. Go figure. It was too loud for a house noise. I'm thinking it could have been like a predator bird got up on the heater vent or something and was, whacking its prey against it or something. I don't know. That's all I got. I don't see stuff, man.
Or just whacking in general.
Just the whacking. Just the mysterious whacking.
Do you ever whack birds? Like just for fun? Like just take a stick and just whack them?
No.
Whack-a-mole? You ever played whack-a-mole?
I don't like where this question line of questioning is going.
Well, you're not very good. I'm pretty good at that game. I win it every time.
Yeah, I'll bet.
Actually, I wasn't even going anywhere. I just like that game, Whack-A-Mole.
Well, who doesn't like whacking?
Oh, yeah. Whacking. Amy?
Yes?
Can you interview A-Hole? You're probably better at it than me.
Can I interview A-Hole?
Please?
Okay, well, I mean, this is kind of sudden. Let's see. Oh, okay. So you haven't had anything really paranormal. You mentioned one incident. Was there something else?
I see the other sort of mysterious thing that comes to mind is we used to have when I was a young boy, we had a cat. I'd play with a cat. And the cat, I don't know, the cat was on the bed and I was, you know, was getting ready to go to sleep and I was fooling with the cat. I noticed the cat was following my hand around when my hand was under the covers. And it wasn't like my hand was touching the covers. I had my hand like sort of away from the covers. So we're talking sheet, blanket, maybe two blankets. And I would move my hand around and the cat's head would follow it. And I never quite figured that out. Because that shit's pretty opaque.
They have pretty good hearing.
Yeah, I was not making noise. It was just hand moving around in the air, not touching anything. So I don't know. Cool. That seemed mysterious. But that's pretty dull. I mean, I don't have any ghosts. I don't have any apparitions to talk about.
What about UFOs?
Oh, when I was in junior high school, I saw them every night. But what? I had just started reading Frank Edwards, so every friggin' light in the sky was a UFO to me.
Yeah, it's kind of like going out on a road trip. You see something, you follow it for like 45 minutes, and then all of a sudden it turns, and you realize it's a plane.
Yeah, I finally got that under control, and haven't seen anything myself. They're pretty good friend of mine. 30 years plus, very solid guy, very no-nonsense guy, extremely no-nonsense guy, and he sort of finally confessed to me one night he had seen a giant black triangle over his house. So that kind of impressed me. I don't tell that story as in I'm presenting this as evidence because, you know, it's hearsay. So it only works for me because I know the guy. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So
you've heard my dad's stories.
I probably heard some of that, but I hear a lot of stuff, and some of it just kind of falls out the other side.
Okay.
You can refresh my memory. What was that?
Well, I mean, I brought him on for the first podcast I did for Haunted Skeptic, just mostly because I wanted to have some sort of documentation of it all. You know, this is something my dad's talked about for most of my life, and I felt like I at least owed him something like that, so I would have at least some sort of a record so that if something happened to him, then, you know, I would be able to hear those stories again. But I wasn't very I didn't really take a skeptical approach with him then. I just let him tell his stories. And then later on, I had an episode for my current show, and I let him come back on and talk about the same thing again, pretty much. But anyway, he claims to have seen a lot of things. Some of the more interesting ones that he claims to have seen were the large triangles and I forget whether or not it was the front or backyard at my grandmother's house, but these were like near an airbase. So, but he and my mother and her sister claimed to have seen this giant triangular object outside my grandmother's house, just hovering above the trees, just right above the trees, not very far off the ground. They said it was completely silent. You know, it was just kind of slow moving kind of thing, and really no good explanation for it. He said there were lights that went around it, and yeah, these stories, you know, he's told most of my life, and I'm like, this is really incredible because I've never seen anything like this before. There was another couple of stories he had about seeing silver discs. He was out hunting. He had taken a student out hunting, and this was during a different era. But he had, of course, gotten permission from the student's family, I guess. I wasn't there. I wasn't even around then. But he took this student out hunting. He was like a troubled kid or something, and I guess just wanted to connect with him. And they ended up seeing these silver discs out on a farm. In just this clearing near the woods. And they said these silver discs, he said one of the silver discs turned into a pillar of smoke. But yeah, that he described fleeing the area. There was another similar incident that he had that. But yeah, just growing up, I've never personally seen anything.
Definitely too many people on Skype. That's too many people on Skype. That's what's going on. It was, yeah. It was really clear when it was just four. The fifth person comes on, and that's what happens. You get the buffering problem. That's what I see what's going on here.
Yeah. Okay, I got most of that. Now. Anyway, I think. Sorry.
Yeah, but that's, I mean, again, I was not there for any of that. But just hearing those stories kind of over and over growing up, you know, it makes me think, well, I don't know what they saw, and I don't think they knew what they saw. You know, if they did see something because they were near an Air Force base, if they saw something odd, you know, I would think that it had something to do with, you know, something that was going on with the Air Force base. But I really have no explanation for, you know, this silent giant triangular object they said they saw, or these disc-shaped objects that he saw fairly up close, not just, you know, something pretty far off, according to him. They were very close to him, and it's just really interesting to me and kind of frightening.
Yeah, it's intriguing. Oddly, my buddy who had an atypical sighting in that he said it was so loud that it shook the house, and he went outside to see what was making all the noise, to see, you know, big ass triangle going overhead.
I think those are ours. I don't know. I've never heard a story where the big triangle takes off and then just disappears up into the sky into space. They're always just floating over near the ground silently, or actually making that weird noise, a big loud noise too. Usually they're just silent.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy in my old age saying that there's stuff I don't know about. I don't have to draw a conclusion one way or the other. And I've gone around full circle on UFOs from that stage when I was in junior high school and affected by the books and seeing them everywhere, and then kind of getting tuned into some of the debunking of some of the crap I've been reading and finding out about hoaxes and folks who see stuff that isn't there, and, you know, liars in general. So I kind of went the, you know, hardened skeptic the other way, and kind of came back from that, and kind of have to remind myself on a regular basis that, yeah, there's still stuff kicking around we don't know about, probably. But yeah, I have drawn no conclusions.
At what point did you feel like you became more of a skeptic?
That was more, you know, I saw a pretty good, I'd read Von Däniken about the same time, Chariots of the Gods, and and sucked all that down, and then saw some pretty convincing debunking of a lot of what he was pushing, and realized I'd been had on a lot of those points. Basically on him, I can't name all of them. The thing that sticks in my mind is he would, Von Däniken would show like a picture of the drawings on the plains of, what is it? Plains of Nazgar?
Yeah, the Nazca lines.
Nazca lines, yeah. And there's one in his book.
He created one of those, didn't he?
Yeah, there was one in his book where it had a caption like, "And this doesn't this this is the form of a bird, but doesn't it look like the taxiways at a modern airport?" And well, yes, it did. And then I saw somebody else with a photo of the same thing, only with a wider perspective, and the dude's standing over it, and the thing's no more than 10 feet across. And I'm like, yeah, Von Däniken, you're just a big fat liar. And stuff like
clever
that.
Clever editing.
Yeah, he was selling books. So, mm-hmm. And then I had to kind of eventually come back from that and turn around and go like, okay, just because there's charlatans and liars doesn't necessarily discount everything. So
what's the biggest thing that bothers you about, I guess, the UFO and paranormal communities, respectively?
Well, you know, it's the noise level between hoaxers. And I don't have too much against hoaxers because I tried to hoax UFOs once myself. It was a miserable failure. But that's another story. And the...
you were a hoaxer.
I sort of half-assed tried once. It was a noble effort. There were.
Was it more like a personal experiment, or were you actually trying to convince like a whole bunch of people?
There were garbage bags, helium, and light sticks involved. I'll tell you this story sometime. But anyway, God bless the true believers, but you know, there's a lot of these folks who look at stuff, and I look at the same stuff, and I just don't see what it is they're looking at. You know, there are folks who will, there are accounts of folks who would declare they're seeing a UFO landing, and somebody hands them binoculars, and they can see that it's a plane on the runway, and they come back with, well, it was a flying saucer, it morphed into a plane. Like, no, at some point you need to admit that some lights in the sky are just lights in the sky, and there are planes and stuff.
I got a buddy that he saw a plane stop in midair and just stay there for like 5 or 10 minutes. It stayed hovering and it still looked like a plane. And there was multiple witnesses that saw this.
I have to
be perspective.
Yeah, I have to reserve judgment on that, but because
you're probably on mushrooms.
Well, it comes, well, this is coming very third hand. So, and you know, this is where I get to say, yeah, I have no opinion on that. But you know, there's no shortage of stories. I had a friend in elementary school who I later figured out was basically a compulsive liar. And he had told a bunch of crazy stories, and I believed them all. And I stopped believing him at a point where they started getting just too crazy. And I kind of later realized that he's a liar. And there's people in this world who, you know, are liars, who would lie. As the saying goes, they would lie when the truth would save them. And, you know, they don't need, Heather likes to say, well, this person has no reason to lie. Well, is it? Well, they don't need a reason to lie. There are liars. That's not a good basis for accepting evidence. It's exactly. Concluding that they have no reason to lie.
Like me. In fact,
what's that?
Like me. I just lie just for the hell of it. No.
Could be. No, I don't know. That's why I'm so happy that I don't have to judge.
let me tell you a story and tell me what you think of this one. One time my brother and I saw an albino panther lurking around the farm. This thing was slinking like a cat, it was bigger than a wolf. It was definitely a cat, and it was pure white. That thing was just crazy looking.
That would be crazy looking. I don't know.
You know who might know more about it?
I looked into
not necessarily know more about it, but may have heard about other sightings. Lauren Coleman, because he tracks all the cat sightings, among other things.
Yeah, Darren said
Wolfman's stories have always been the same. That's pretty good. I like that. That's because I'm telling what I saw, what I actually saw. And usually there's other people with me there. So, that was weird. I don't know. It could have been an escape animal.
I appreciate you telling your stories. I don't have a problem with that. And as I say, the reason I don't have a problem with that is because I don't have to judge.
That's good. Judging is for the those people that are what would you call them? In need of a good bonking.
All right, where's Ugg when we need him?
I just heard a bonk in there, but you guys won't hear it.
You know what? I used to have more of a passion for knowing the truth behind all these things. But really? I've sort of gotten over that.
Yeah. It's weird when you... Yuck's back.
Oh, baby.
Right on, and there's no Skype buffering. That's weird. I wonder why I did it before. Oh, well. Skype likes you now.
It sucks, man.
I'm hearing an echo.
What did you say? Because it's not a video?
No, I'm hearing an echo.
Oh, yeah, I heard the echo, too. I turned myself down more.
Who's that?
That's Yuck Nasty.
Yuck.
Wow. Did you do that on purpose sometimes, though, Yuck?
No, I don't, man. On purpose, you... Look, as soon as I say something, I'm fucking... God damn, bro.
Mind locked people judge.
So are there 6 people on this call right now?
Yeah, including me. Yeah, there's 5 on my screen. Marcus, are you still there?
I'm still here.
Oh, yeah. Jeff, what have you got to add? Or Marcus, what do you guys got to add?
Well, I have, you know, with you seeing your, you know, whatever things that you've seen and you have multiple people seeing the same things, you know, I've been in that situation where we all reacted the same way, you know, and we saw something, and it's kind of hard to, I guess, be skeptical about that when you and, you know, 2 other people you're with respond the same way to seeing something that is, I don't know, paranormal.
Well, I'll tell you, when we saw that cat, my brother was with me, and we were working on some tractors, and my kids were outside playing. We went and grabbed those kids and ran in the house with them. That thing was scary looking, man. We didn't know what to do because we didn't even have guns on the farm. And it's not easy to get guns in Canada. I think there might be a gun around somewhere, but my dad kept it well hidden from us. When we were younger, we got a hold of my grandfather's gun, and we liked to blow things up. We'd get cans of gas and try to blow them up, and it didn't work. The bullets won't blow up gas cans. They just pops a hole in them, and they leak out. So we ended up using flaming arrows, and that worked.
Flaming arrows?
Yeah, we tied rags around and then dipped it in diesel oil and then lit it on fire and shot that at the gas can. And, oh, yeah, then it blew up.
Yeah, I was a bit of a pyro in my younger days, yeah.
Yeah, it was fun.
Did you play with chemistry, too?
Nice that I've still got all my fingers.
Did you play with chemistry sets and make poison mustard gas, too?
No.
Yeah. I don't know what I made. I made this poisonous gas one time. I almost killed myself in the garage.
No. We wanted to see if we could fill a balloon with propane, and then maybe we'd like tie something onto it, light it on fire, and it would go up in the sky and burst into flame. And then I found out that propane is much heavier than air. And when you fill a balloon with it, it drops like a rock.
Yeah, but we did that too, but we shot flaming arrows at the... They blow up really good. Propane-filled balloons blow up really good. Makes a great explosion with a flaming arrow. Oh, yeah.
I shot bottle rockets out of PVC pipe, maybe about 10-foot PVC pipe, and launched them across a farm one time. That was fun. And then I daisy-chained a bunch of bottle rockets together. That was also fun. And that was in the middle of a Floridian neighborhood, a very populated neighborhood. That was really stupid. But, yeah, that's... Yeah.
Well, my buddy had, he had his, first I had my grandpa's gun, a Belgian rifle of some sort, and we broke the pin on that one, and then I think my mom took it away, and they hit it on us, but then, my buddy got a war rifle that was a knockdown, like you could take it all apart and stick it right into the hilt, or the part, you know, the hilt, that... comes into your arm. I don't know what you call it.
Stock?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think it's stock, yeah. All the parts of the gun would go into that, so you could sneak around with this gun and then put it together. And then his brother found out, and he was in the army, his brother found out he had that gun, and then his brother took it away from him, too, and gave him a few smacks. Boy, was he mad. We were blowing things up, and we didn't hurt anyone.
Yeah. I'm going to say, I'm just glad I still have the fingers.
And all 11 digits.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think it's time I put on a song or something.
See, am I a hypocrite for saying I'm not judging people when I get on DM Talk and rag all over the
obvious
nut crazes? Yeah,
yeah, yeah, you're full of shit. You're absolutely full of shit.
I know. You know, there's a certain threshold when they're on there saying, you know, well, I was wrestling with gray aliens that were in my apartment and rummaging through my things and. One of them morphed into my brother, and meanwhile, there's black helicopters hovering outside. You know, there's a certain threshold where you just go, yeah, that's just fucking crazy.
Yeah, I mean, I think the people I have a really big problem with are the ones that are very obviously trying to take advantage of people who don't know better.
Oh, I got a great story for you. When I was jamming, we were 16 years old, and we were jamming in my parents' basement, and we were fooling around with tarot cards back then and Ouija boards, and all of a sudden my brother got possessed. I would say possessed, when his eyes rolled back into his head and all you could see was the whites of his eyes, and he started speaking in a language that we didn't understand, and it didn't sound like any other language we ever heard before, and he was playing the bass so wicked, but it was different. It was different than I've ever heard him play before. He's never done it since, and yes, you know, it was just really weird. And we stopped playing after a while and just stared at him like, what the hell is going on? And we actually had to pry the bass out of his hands. And then we got so scared of, like, and then he didn't remember any of it. When he sort of woke up out of this trance, he didn't remember any of that. And then we burned the tarot, we burned the tarot deck, and we burned the Ouija board, and the tarot deck would not burn. It wouldn't burn no matter what we put on it, gas and everything, it would not burn. And the Ouija board burned up, but it ended up in his closet the next day, back where, you know, after we burned it up, it ended up back in his closet somehow.
I don't know if I buy that.
Well, I wouldn't buy it either. I wouldn't pay any money for that kind of shit. It's scary.
No, I don't know if I believe that or not.
I know. That's what
because
happened.
I've got a Ouija. I have an Ouija board.
We never did drugs back then. We never drank. We didn't do drugs. We just did music.
So, A-hole, have you ever played with an Ouija board before?
Probably. I kind of think maybe yes. Don't have nothing to report. It's a piece of cardboard with printing on it to me.
It's nothing exciting. Nothing exciting for me.
But I don't know. It's interesting phenomena as far as people. I don't know. What can you say? I had an aunt who was scared of a Ouija board. I heard threw it out.
It is the expectation of fear.
But I don't know. And then I mean, clearly there's means for people to get into some kind of alternate state, and what you want to chalk that up to is up for grabs. But I mean, you know, you can go back all the dancing thing, sort of medieval vintage.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean, people seem to be susceptible to getting into weird states, and it, I don't know what that's about.
I don't know either.
I'm back. This is Darren, you guys.
Welcome back.
Have you ever been hypnotized? Do you guys believe in hypnotists?
Hypnotized.
I've never tried it.
Yeah, my son's been hypnotized a couple times at the state fair, and it's real. I don't know how it works exactly. I didn't get hypnotized, but I know that he was. He could call in and tell you all about it. But a lot of people think it's fake too. But it's real. I believe it's real, anyways.
I've seen a guy once take a balloon and he made him believe it was his vagina.
Yeah, it's crazy.
that's kind of a stretch there.
No, it's the guy really thought it was his vagina. He was a girl, and the balloon, one of those.
It's a stretch between a balloon and a vagina in my mind, but.
No, he, you know how the clowns twist those long balloons? He made it into a shape that's sort of like a...
See, yeah. I would have gone in the other direction from a vagina when you talk about those balloons. Yeah, it was very much the opposite of a vagina.
It's inside out.
Well, okay. All right.
When I was younger, speaking of hypnosis, I was in the fifth grade, and I was in one of these programs. It was like an accelerated learning program, and me and a few other kids, we were in this. They had this portable, like a trailer outside of the school, and we would go to class out there, and. One day our teacher went on maternity leave, and they thought they had sent us a substitute teacher, but for several weeks we went to this class and we didn't have a substitute. So we had to make up things to do in our free time other than playing Oregon Trail. One of the kids brought in Whitley Strieber's Communion, and we all proceeded to attempt hypnosis on him. And I got really afraid. I thought because it was the aim of the other kids to make him do something stupid while he's in this state of mind. And I was really afraid, and I decided to abort this thing. But later on, of course, you know, you find out that things like regressive hypnosis are just absolute bunk. Really, there's no basis for it whatsoever, and you know, a lot of the people that still practice it know damn good and well that the brain doesn't necessarily work that way, but they still do it anyway. So, you know,
yeah,
Hey,
I guess you probably saw the Penn and Teller bullshit show where they take on regressive hypnosis.
Actually, I haven't.
Spoiler, they interview a woman who does regressive hypnosis, and she's got shit right there in her office where she hypnotizes people. She's got like little alien dolls and stuff, little grays and whatnot, you know.
It's like suggestion much?
Yeah, stuff that would be a joke in any other office, but in the lady who's doing the regression hypnosis, why is this there?
Well, obviously, if, you know, these people are going to her, they feel like they've had some sort of an experience like that, and they're seeking her out. They must be seeking her out because she does some sort of service for people who feel like they've been abducted by aliens.
Yeah. That was her gig, yeah.
Yeah. So there's already an expectation there, and then you have the imagery, you know, and that's and then you kind of go from there.
Yeah, you guys haven't heard Wolfman's abduction story, have you?
Nope.
I was trying to get him to go into regression therapy a few weeks ago, wasn't I, Wolfman?
Please don't do that. please don't. It's they take advantage of people. Psychologists and psychiatrists, they know damn good and well that it's not supported anymore, and it's really frowned upon because it does people a lot of disservice.
Is Wolfman still there? I guess he's gone.
I have kind of a little thing for Amy because she's all into the neurology stuff. I was at one of the Burning Man regionals 2 years ago in Arizona. Mm-hmm. And the various theme camps are set up, these things, and one of them was this I don't know what it was, Dr. Saguaro's eye or something, but anyway, it was one of these things where you go in and stare at their blinking light and see things. And I thought, yeah, this is something for stoned hippies to go in and, after they've been maybe dropping a little bit of acid, and stare at blinky lights and see things. And but I went over there, some friends of mine were walking around and they wanted to go see it, so they drugged me along, and I ended up going in for this thing. They had to sign a hold harmless form that was like basically exempting them from anything that could possibly go bad, and they gave us stern warnings about if you're prone to seizures, you don't want to do this, etc.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's
so we go
sense.
In there inside the darkened tent, and there's like a light bulb hanging from overhead, and it's down inside of a vertical cylinder that has various holes in it, and the cylinder is rotating on literally on a phonograph turntable. Mm-hmm. So it's really low tech. And I go, oh, okay. So what do? You sit down in front of it real close, put your face up really close to the spinning cylinder, and close your eyes. And so with the spinning, the holes, you're seeing basically flashes of light in through your closed eyes. And he says, you may need to adjust your distance and move around and see different effects. And I'm still thinking, yeah, okay, I don't know. Maybe I'll see something-ish. And within about 20 seconds, I started to see shit. I was seeing concentric circles with radiating lines and rotating shit and all manner of stuff. And I'm like, holy fucking shit, this works!
That was kind of the thing. That's that thing has a name, that specifically, I think it's like a dream something. What you're describing, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah, I think people do it with, like, you could do the same thing with like LEDs and strobing them at different rates and pulse lengths, probably, because that's essentially what you'd move your head around between. There were different size holes and different spacing, so you're essentially, by moving your head, you could get a different frequency and a different pulse width and things like that.
Yeah.
So I sort of imagine this is probably hitting on some kind of refresh rate that's going on in the brain and messing it up. And, you know, I just mild speculation. And I only had a mild headache afterward.
Yeah. I mean, I felt really weird after I first experimented with the Ganzfeld effect. And, you know, I first did not know really what to expect, but I thought, well, I probably will not experience anything. And just messing around
with
that.
I heard you describing the effects quite a lot.
That's very similar to what I was going to do tonight. Was a game called, it's not really a game, but it's really what you're talking about, what you stare into somebody else's eyes in the dark. It's got to be a really dark room, and with some kind of staticky white noise, or you know, even just wind blowing or something ambient sort of noise. But it's mostly just the dark and staring at each other's eyes, and it just, you don't take your eyes off the other person. And after a while, you start seeing shit. It just everything.
Sensory deprivation.
I think if you stare at anything long enough, things start to get a little wonky. I've done that.
Mm-hmm.
The weirdest thing that happened to me while doing that, I'm sort of remembering weird shit now that I think of it, was I don't know what I was staring at, but it was just kind of like fixed at one point in the room. And at some point, I think your retinas are kind of just turning, giving you kind of a negative image of what you were seeing in the first place. It's maybe some sort of eyeball effect, I don't know.
Yeah.
I think I was getting into some sort of meditative state almost by accident. At one point, the weirdest thing that happened was I sort of felt like my hands went backwards. It was like I could feel the thumb on the opposite side of my hands. Like think of the Outer Limits episode where the guy gets his hand flipped. It was sort of like that. I sort of came down from that, and I said, God, that was neat.
That actually reminds me of one of the Exorcist clips that Mr. Haunted played, where you hear the little girl saying, my arm is on backwards.
Yeah.
But he said her arm really did contort into a really strange, unnatural position.
Yeah, but my brother can do that, and he's been able to do that most of his life.
I don't know. It was she didn't sound like she was enjoying it. That was really actually creepy. Did you guys hear that?
These times I don't judge.
Yeah, it's that line between, you know, people who experience things and they feel like they have had something happen to them, and you know, people who obviously, very, very obviously seem like they haven't experienced something and are just trying to bullshit everybody for some sort of gain or attention or profit. You know, there's that end of it. But, you know, usually I don't reserve judgment for these things. But I do think of, you know, possibilities like, you know, how might someone perceives something differently and maybe jump to the conclusion of paranormal when it's something totally natural happening.
Yeah, there's kind of this gulf, I guess, that sort of, maybe this is the skeptic believer gulf or something. There was just the other night, there was a guest on MITD and they who had taken a spooky picture. And he was talking about the spooky picture he'd taken of the being that he had seen, and with his old digital camera, and this went on for a while. And of course, it's up on the website, so I'm going like, oh, okay, let me go look and see what we're talking about. And I looked at that picture, and I looked at that picture, and I looked at that picture. Where is it? I'm seeing it's an old photograph on a digital camera. So of course the resolution's poor, and there's artifacts and stuff. So. Which you expect to see. And then I noticed a little farther down, he's got kind of labeled parts of what were apparently supposed to be the face he saw in what was just to me, an artifact of the photo. And I see stuff like that fairly regularly. I mean, sometimes you see something like, okay, well, that looks like a spooky face, but then you see the stuff where like, how did you get a face out of that?
Yeah.
Where did that come
from?
That's
obviously pareidolia. I visited the ancient Ram Inn And that's in Watton under Edge, I think, in the UK. But it's, you know, this place is supposed to be one of the most haunted places in all of England. When I went there, I did not feel anything weird. I didn't see anything weird. You know, I found this guy there who just seemed kind of haunted by himself. And a lot of people that kind of seemed to scare him into believing in a lot of things. But then there were, out of all the photographs we took of this place, there were a couple that just, I have no explanation for them. They just don't make any sense, because I've got the photographs from different angles, you know, and I can account for everything that should be in these photographs, except for, you know, this one anomaly. And there's two of them like that really stand out. One is this, it's a reflection. It seems to be a reflection in a painting, like this painting has a, you know, piece of glass over it, and it seems to be a reflection, you know, off that glass. But in the photo, you can very clearly see, you know, in the part that's not the reflection, you can see a spinning wheel, you can see this silly little King Tut head figure thing, and then a place where this reflected object should be, and it's not, and it looks like me. And I didn't take the picture. I wasn't even in the room. And you can see the room. It looks like a person, and it looks like me in there, you know, in this reflection. And it's very clear. I could send it to you. I don't really want to publish it, you know, because this, I really don't want to give too much attention.
Everyone
to this
would
place.
Laugh
like
at you.
Much given.
Everyone would laugh at you. You know.
But then there's this other photo that obviously looks like there's some sort of a face and some kind of creature or something. It's just really freaky looking. I don't know what it is. It doesn't look like artifacting.
This goes back to what I was talking, I guess, mentioning noise level before, is that, I mean, there's a certain amount of stuff that is intriguing and you go like, well, that's kind of weird. I'd kind of like to know more about that. And it's a lot of that stuff is sort of masked by, I don't know, people who have a very different, their brains are working overtime trying to see patterns and things that aren't there.
Yeah, paradoxical.
And it's, you know, I don't want to spoil anyone's fun, but at the same time, I go like, yeah, I don't know. It complicates the picture. It just complicates the overall picture if you get into the mood to want to try to unravel this stuff. So yeah, it's, and some of it's just extreme. Like again, that photo the other night, I was just blown away. Like, oh, it's another one of these where there's just nothing there. They're looking at, it's like looking at clouds and they're seeing a duck or a horsey, you know. And if the cloud was spelling out, you know, the first two paragraphs of the Gettysburg Address, then I'd have to say, yeah, you got something there.
I'm
any of you guys, has anyone here ever seen, like when you're, say, brushing your hair or something, have you ever seen another face in the mirror behind you and then turn around and look and there's nothing there?
I will say no.
I will say that I've seen some pretty weird reflection things and just like a faucet or something.
Buffering problem.
Yeah, it gets weird. You know, the human brain is, as has been said many times, is all about pattern matching. I mean, that's kind of what brains do best.
Yeah, so I just sent this image over to you, A-hole. I'll let you take a look at it. Help me figure out what it is.
To my what?
I want it too.
I'm sorry, to your
it's on direct.
I just DM'd it to you on Twitter. It's one of those things that, you know, if it has an obvious explanation, I don't want to call too much attention to it. And it's, you know, something that I might have overlooked, but
well, it's slow to load. I think scary things are involved.
Oh, it's okay. Definitely probably Heather. She put a spell.
Okay, so where is what I would be looking at?
Okay, the reflection of the wider, it looks like a wider mirror, but that's actually a painting.
Like over the headboard of the bed?
Yes.
Okay.
Do you see there's three objects by the window?
Yeah.
And one of those don't look like they belong there.
One of these things is not like the other.
Okay, so the thing on the right side in the reflection then.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. I would, so that's a painting. It would be helpful to know what the,
yeah, okay. So let me find some of the pictures.
This has got to be awfully dull for anyone listening to this conversation.
Oh, not at all. Because I keep jumping in with stupid shit.
Well, yeah, it's your show.
I think it's time to play a song, though. I seriously do. You guys like Mike Oldfield?
I don't know.
Yeah, sure.
Try this out.
Tubular Bells.
This is not Tubular Bells. It's called Minutes. It's from his latest album.
Oh, okay.
Like hours, and hours that seem like days. The ones you want all the same.
Oh, it's loud.
Turn it down.
Yeah, I know, I don't like that. I need to try that again. It was too much gain on that, eh? It's a different device. Yeah, let me try this.
Quite a bit.
It's a different device, so I can try this. No, not that. Oh, stupid. You know what? TuneIn Radio keeps trying to jump in on it. That's gay. Stop.
So, Amy, you're talking about the kind of upside down U on the right?
The upside down U?
You sort of U shape to the right? In the reflection?
Okay, so. In the reflection of this thing, to me, it looks like I can see, it looks kind of like I see a face and hair and something kind of leaning over and looking in into this.
Now, is this something that we can see too, or no?
Can you throw it on Skype?
Okay, I'll put it up on the Skype. Let's see if I can get into the Skype chat over here. This will be terribly unhelpful to anybody else who's listening. Let's see. You know what? It says messaging unavailable.
In the park, the
That's a gray.
That is a gray alien.
That's what you think.
Here, it's me, definitely a gray alien.
The original. I'm trying to get all these over here.
Okay, I have this.
I love it. That's an awesome picture.
Oh yeah. Well, what do you think? What do you think of that red bedroom, the bishop's room?
I haven't got the first picture. It's not quite in yet.
Okay, so in the reflection, there's the spinning wheel on the left in the reflection.
Mm-hmm.
And then to the right of that, there's the sort of bumpy thing that one might imagine is an alien, which looks like it corresponds to the bumpy thing in the middle of the window there. I don't know what that thing is in front of the window, but it's... I imagine you knew what that was, right?
The thing in the middle of the window is a King Tut statue.
Right. Well, that looks like that's what I'm seeing to the right of the spinning wheel and the reflection, right?
Yes. And then to the right of that.
If you look at the left side of the window... At the wall, there's a sort of a beam coming down from the wood beam coming down from the window under the curtain. There's a narrower sort of beam sticking out horizontally from about curtain level to the other wood beam, vertical wood beam on to the left of that. And that kind of looks like all that stuff there to me. And it may be with some stuff added from the painting. If you look at the painting right about in that position, you've got that sailing ship with the darker sail. I don't know if that could be any of that in there. I guess if you wanted to get real particular about it, you could maybe, if you knew what you were doing with Photoshop, you could maybe stretch the painting photo out to match the reflection photo, and then you could overlay them and see where the painting maps out to the stuff you're seeing. But
I wish I had a picture of the exact from the exact same angle with the flash on. Because that would be more telling. I could overlay the two.
Yeah, that I think that stuff there is just mostly the beams and stuff on that piece of the wall, maybe with a combination of what's the stuff in the photo. There's kind of a dark lump. There's sort of the darker, slightly tilting vertical line there has got like a dark lump coming off of it that kind of looks like the back sail on that ship. It's hard to say.
No, I can see it.
Yes.
But, you know, gray alien. Gray alien's more fun.
This is a different... That was a different photo. Let me send you that one. That's the second photo. let's see. I'm trying to access everything on the Google Drive.
So wait a minute.
The first photo, is that somebody that you know that's leaning down?
Yes, that was my friend that was with me.
And what's strange about that picture then?
Oh, I'm sorry. Let's see. The one that I sent you, give me just a second. I'm trying to send these over to A-hole.
Is what's in the mirror above the bed?
Yeah, don't suggest too much. I think I'm afraid we already have suggested too much.
I never really listened to, I just noticed it myself. There's, it looks like three people in front of that mirror.
Let's see. Oh yeah, in that picture, the one that we were talking about. See, I'm trying to figure out whether or not that's just some sort of an illusion. It's got to be. It has to be some sort of an illusion. But it really does look strange. All right, I'm sending this one over to A-hole, and and the other one where I've enhanced it. Oh,
I
imagine people listening to this show that don't realize your Twitter name and she keeps calling you an asshole.
That was sort of how it was intended. You know, I came up with that because I sort of expected to be just, everyone would just assume I would treat me as an asshole on when I started snarking on the DM talk, and to my huge disappointment, they all turned out to be friendly and nice. So,
but we're just
yeah.
As
what's
nasty,
up with
though.
That? All those friendly people on DM talk.
Yeah, but then again, too, I think we're all responsible for getting booted off the network's Twitter feed.
I'm not. I wasn't on there talking about it.
I did.
I wasn't on there during the time. I shut my mouth.
I was right there with all the nasties.
Oh, there was, I don't know. Yeah, I've got the story about right after Keith had shut that down I had tweeted something fairly innocent to someone else about the hashtags, I thought, and Keith jumped into that and said, well, then I'll just stop because he said he was going to just retweet select DM talk tweets, which actually I thought would have been fine because it would have kept publicity for the hashtag going. And then I don't know why he took our conversation that way, but he said, well, I'll just stop doing that. I won't retweet it at all. And I tried to engage him in a conversation for the first time and sort of talk him down. And I was going to attempt to convince him that, you know, shutting off the contaminated feed was all he really, the only thing he needed to be responsible for. That should satisfy his sponsors. If his sponsors had any kind of brain in their head, they'd know that he didn't control a hashtag on Twitter and social media. All kinds of crazy things get said on unmoderated social media, and it's not his responsibility. And, you know, it would be fine for him to retweet harmless hashtag tweets that he liked. That would be good. And in the midst of me trying to do this, there were like two other DM talkers jumping in and just trolling the hell out of him. Just heaving insults while I was trying to talk him down. I don't know. I thought it was hilarious.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I know. I was one of them too. Me and Jeff were right in there like dirty shirts.
Yeah. I couldn't help it. He left the
All right,
door
so
open.
There's a photo. There's a guy taking a picture of a selfie in a mirror.
In
or,
a mirror. Yes, it's some sort of a mirror.
And it's I see a European light switch, so I know it ain't America.
And, nope.
And there's like kind of streaky reflections on the mirror that suggest to me that it's not a super clean mirror.
No, it's not.
Or it's got that thing where the silvering is delaminating from the back or something. But I don't know. Is there a scary face somewhere? What am I?
Yeah, there's supposed to be. Do you see the second picture?
I see it.
Second picture. Oh, this is another person with the camera.
It's unmistakable for me because I've seen them before.
I've sent you many pictures.
That's this a really is this elf. Is the
They have hooves. They walk in the snow with Johnny L. Tenney.
Wow.
What?
They have hooves.
The Jersey Devils in here somewhere?
It's an elf.
It's an elf.
No.
I'm looking at the person who's closer up.
Okay, so there's the long picture that I sent you, and then I enhanced. There's this kind of yellow version. Of it, where I've enhanced
the photo a little bit.
Yeah.
Hope my old Mac don't crash.
I'll send you another one so it crashes.
somebody else has called in. Who is this? So there's a caller on.
So there's okay. So we're looking at this the greatly zoomed in thing. So there's
The blob monster.
Blob monster, the sort of pointy face blob monster. That one.
Yeah, kind of. It's got like a looks almost like somebody's shoulder. If I didn't know better, I would say it's a reflection of his tattoo. But I've got different angles of that picture. You can kind of see in the first picture of this, the blue bottle with the white on it, like the white stripe on it. Then from the other camera angle, I was taking another picture of that area. I was just taking random pictures. There's the bottle again. You can see blue bottle with white. And then
where's that off on the left? I know
it's to the right. It's actually behind me, and I'm shooting into the mirror.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Right. And let's see. I thought I sent this other one over. I guess I didn't. And this is the rest of what's behind that area.
You know, it's probably just pareidolia. I think that's probably why the Native Indians carved totem poles. Actually, they looked at the tree knots and they could see faces in there, and they thought, "I'm going to carve that out, that face."
Could be.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? I was staring at a tree once. I could see all kinds of faces in it. If you just stare at it long enough, the tree knots start to look like eyes and mouths and stuff, and you almost feel like just going and carving it out. The animal faces, like you could make a totem pole. You just stare at it long enough.
Yeah.
Just carve it out and make it look more like what you're seeing, you know? You know what? We ate up this show, man. It's 24 minutes left.
I've been on the radio for almost 5 hours today.
6 hours for me, I guess. Well, 5 and a half now. A little over. I'm getting pretty tired. When you guys are talking and I'm not, I'm drifting off.
Well, it's just us.
That's all right.
Yeah, we're boring.
No, well, I'm tired.
There's a hole full of garbage here.
Yes, it's this little place is under some stairs, and this is where one of the local universities. I don't know how. They found these remains. There were some human remains found there all throughout this place. There are just random spots in this old pub/inn where the floor is just destroyed, and you see these little holes of dirt. You've got confirmation from the universities that they did remove Neolithic human remains from some of these areas, and some of them a little bit more recent than that.
Tenth
century, but
No, Ralph there, he collapsed while he was drinking his pint, and we just took him down to the cellar because, you know, it's a long way to the cemetery.
Well, a lot of these things, they found like children's bones and things, and I don't know if it was the thought of the university or if it's just wild imaginations, but there are some people that think that there were like some child sacrifices at the site at one point.
All right, give me the shortcut to the spooky stuff here. What am I looking at more?
All right, so the shortcut to the spooky stuff, there's supposed to be this weird looking head thing that is in this one photograph that's caught in the reflection of the mirror. It's not I can't readily account for it. Other than the fact that the mirror is dirty, I take pictures of the mirror. I don't see that weird face anywhere else. I have video of this area, and it helps me to account for more of the objects in there. I mean, there's a blue bottle in there that I can see in one photo. Turn around, you can see it again when you're looking at the trash area. You can see it to the left of the photo. Actually, there's two bottles, but the one that I'm referring to is the lighter blue and white and black bottle. You can see that clearly in the photos with me, except for the one where my arm is covering it. But that part of the door frame, or that area that framed the area under the stairs, in one photo where I've snapped a picture of myself in the mirror, I don't see, you know, any weird faces or anything, but it certainly seems to appear in the face, or in the photo with my friend there.
Gray alien with a booger hanging down his nose.
Yeah, I don't know what I'm looking at. Where okay, is this?
I'll circle it and send it to you. I'll circle it and send it to you. Here we go.
Is the stairway directly behind the mirror? Where is this?
If with me taking a selfie of myself in the mirror, I'm pointing the camera at the mirror, and it's shooting a picture of the mirror. It's directly behind me. That stairway. Oh, okay.
So that's the stairway thing, and it's just not lit up.
Right. Let's see. I'm going to send you this. Okay, I've now circled the piece of pareidolia or weirdness or whatever it is.
Oh, well, I guess you're talking about the sort of lump on the left there or something.
Yeah, the lump.
Yeah. Boy, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know either. It came off the camera like that, and of course that's just, you know, that's anecdotal from me. But you know, I mean, the one that I circled, obviously, that's been enhanced. But I don't know what it is. My buddy, he has a degree in astrophysics, and he immediately goes, aliens.
Oh man, I think you guys are working too hard. I mean, there's so many, there's like irregular shapes and stuff in that sort of basement access or whatever. Then it's, that's just too much of a stretch. I mean, I can't draw conclusions, is what I'm saying. So.
All right.
So that was a big help. That was worth sending all those photos.
Nothing newsworthy then.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can you draw stick men? If you can't draw conclusions, can you draw stick men?
Anything? That's about as close as I get to rendering a human being. Yeah, stick man would be it.
What is that you're drinking?
You really want to know? Yeah, it's Malibu coconut rum with Sprite.
Oh, that's good.
It is. My bartender friend approves.
Okay, now Jeff's going to interview you guys. Okay, Jeff? I know you're dying to.
Yeah, I don't have anything.
Aw. Marcus?
We're just that dull. Oh, we put him to sleep. Marcus is asleep.
Darren?
I can hear.
He just woke me up.
You guys gotta take over the show. It's your show, man.
It is?
Yeah.
I thought it was a Wolfman Mike show.
Yeah, but it's your show too, man. You're co-hosts. I'm worn out.
Just the peanut gallery here.
I think we're all worn out.
Yeah, it's been a long day. Well, we've done 6 hours.
Yeah, it's coming to a close. We've got 15 minutes left. I just thought if you guys want to say something, now's the time.
Yeah, I snarked like 3 movies today.
Wow.
I should
be in
bed already.
That's good.
Yeah. Which movies?
There was Revenge of the Invisible Man, some Spectre Man episodes, and some crazy thing with Desert Clam there. It was some weird comedy, cop comedy thing with Joe Don Baker that I didn't.
Joe Don Baker.
Yeah, it was like they were trying to make the airplane of horror movie murder thing, and it's just like,
was it when they execution was not. Was it when they'd shown on MST3K?
No. It'll take me a while to find what the title was. I was just looking at it, but it was crazy. It was not they had lofty goals, but the execution wasn't quite there. But it was pretty weird.
Yeah, I tried to watch House by the Cemetery, one of the Lucio Fulci movies, and it was pretty bad. I think I might try it some other time.
Yeah. Do you guys watch The Walking Dead?
Not me.
I've seen it. It's okay.
I've seen it last weekend.
Last weekend's episode. It's gruesome. They said it jumped the shark. A lot of people said they're not going to watch the show anymore.
Oh, really? Well, yeah. It's kind of hard
I'm an old man with no cable. I can't help you there.
Yeah.
Well, with my experience working in a cadaver lab, it's kind of hard to gross me out, so.
Yeah, it was pretty bad.
I doubt
it. You could do it.
It's great, though. The reaction videos are great online. Those
I'm
are
too
more...
much of a... I judge the show too much because it's, I know what it actually looks like to cut up, those pieces, and it doesn't really do it for me, so.
Eesh. Are you still doing that?
Well, tomorrow we're going to have...
Not right now, no.
I got Wisteria Whispers stories to read off, and I think I'm gonna get Adam Watt to read those, because he's got a great voice for that, and he's gonna be.
I'm working with dementia clients right now, so it's a whole nother different game.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
And. I don't know, Marcus, if you could look more into that UFO reporter that was killed by the Black Magic cult, that'd be cool if you could find anything out. Maybe we can play some more of that debate backwards and see if we can catch something in there. that'd be cool.
No probes.
Yeah. I heard it.
No probes.
No probes, he
said. I think that's what Hillary said backwards. No probes.
I thought that was. I thought
you guys,
that was
you guys are taking me right back to the 80s with this backwards masking shit, man.
Oh, God.
Oh, that was fun, wasn't it?
That was actually Jake Dog's idea.
Oh, the debate?
Playing it backwards. He heard that from somewhere that they're doing shit like that in there. And it's just so old and outdated that it's overlooked.
Yeah, I've done it myself with things that I've said, and it just comes out the same thing. It's audio pareidolia. That's all it is.
Yeah,
that's what I said. It's audio pareidolia. Yeah.
It's fun though.
If I were forced to listen to the debates backwards, is how I would want to do it. I'm pretty sure that's the only way I could stomach that crap.
Yeah. If you had to listen to it, you'd rather listen to it backwards. Yeah. I hear you.
Well, I'm going to have to drop off, you guys. It's been great.
Amy, yeah. It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wish I could have been on when you guys were talking about the squatty potty and all that, but I missed all that stuff.
It was definitely entertaining.
Those were the squatty potty were the ones with the sense of humor. And that was the one that broke the camel's back. That was weird.
Was it?
That was the one where I remembered Keith jumping in when one of the guys had, I don't know, it was a photo of the woman in the movie Office Space giving the finger and squatting. Something about that just tripped Keith off, and they went back and forth on that one. And it was ironic with Squatty Potty is like the one sponsor with a huge sense of humor who would, you know, tweet with us and stuff and laughed at our jokes.
Huh. Weird. I've talked to Keith recently on the phone, and he's doing well. we still nice. Get along. We still get along. I don't know. He's different online.
Yeah, and I can't imagine the variety of stuff he has to contend with must be stressful.
Yeah, well, he does go through a lot of stress, and he does a hell of a lot. Really, he does. He does really work his ass off. That is a fact. And when he was doing, you know, all the live shows, I mean, he was, you know, 6 hours doing live shows a day was not abnormal. I mean, I think he was doing even more than that at some point. Because, you know, there were other live shows on the network that weren't MITD or Awesome. But yeah, he was putting in a lot of time. And I think just, you know, when Art, when he left, you know, that for him, that was just, it's like, okay, well, you know, because at that point, you know, he'd been supervising all these live shows because he was trying to build the network for Art's return. And, you know, when Art returned, you know, he had MITD to worry about. I mean, he had all these other shows to worry about. So, you know, then that's why he dropped them off, you know, most of the live shows on the network. And then I guess some slowly came back on as podcast or something. And then, I mean, he's still working pretty hard over there. I mean, he's still got a lot to do and continue with, and you know,
how's the network doing?
Over on his end, I mean, I don't know. You know, the business side of things, I'm not privy to those details anymore. But you know, I think they're doing all right. Sounds like we're doing pretty good.
What do you think the best shows are?
Somebody's building something.
The best there. Shows on their network.
Yeah.
A-hole, what are you building? Are you got? Are you doing some carpentry?
No. Other than, you know,
what?
Carpentry.
My TD is live, you know. So I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't really tune into the other network that much.
Yeah.
I have too much to do on my end, you know. I'm just.
Good diplomatic answer.
When is your show on?
Mine's.
Oh, I believe you. It's still a good diplomatic answer.
Well, mine's 8 p.m. to 11 p.m. Central on Wednesday, Thursday, Fridays, because it takes a lot of my time to plan and write and just produce these live shows. It's not very easy at all. And
yeah.
Certainly not making a living out of it.
Yeah, understood.
It's something you just gotta love doing, and it's.
What do you mean? I'll give you $5 a month.
Well, I appreciate it. I really do, but it's.
You can't live off that.
I can tell you, I've not working even yet, just in terms of expenses, and you know, because I have to pay for two numbers for Skype, and you know, I mean. The show's got bills, and you know, I've not broken even yet. So
I've got
I'd listen and call in, but
I'm
usually working at that time.
We have a donation box,
but I'll try.
But nobody's used it yet.
They're just hoping we quit sometime soon.
Nobody's used what yet?
My donation box on the website. Oh.
You need to plug it more often then.
Yeah, okay. If there's anyone still listening, I need a new computer for my show so that Amy can call in and I don't have to mess around and she gets in on the air right away.
Well, this show will be, I'll post it as soon as the show's over. I'll go ahead and post it on the website so it'll be up.
I do need a new computer.
Dear Lord, I should have thought about that before I called in.
I will have better sound with another better computer. I mean, like, the stuff I'm working with here is like, I'm seriously, Caveman Oog probably has rocks that are more modern than the stuff I'm working with.
Yeah, it needs a little work.
One cord in one of the laptops I'm using, it once in a while it makes a buzzing sound from the, and I gotta twist the cord all the time if I hear that sound.
Oh, yeah.
But you know what I did? I took my compressor from out in the garage and I blew out all the jacks and blew out all the everything. And actually, it made a huge difference for tonight's show because I was going nuts. And then my wife said, why don't you get your compressor in there and blow everything out? Blow out all the keyboards, blow all the jacks out, blow all the cords out. And it worked.
See, you said compressor. I wasn't thinking air compressor. I was thinking like an audio compressor.
No, I'm talking an air compressor to blow all the dust out of everything. Because everything's old. It's really old. And you wouldn't believe the shit I blew out of there. There was clouds of dust coming out of some of the stuff.
Yeah, it probably helped.
It made a huge difference.
Yep. How much time's left in the show? Okay.
Good night, Amy. Go, you guys.
Jeff, do you have anything to plug? We got 4 minutes left.
Good night, Amy.
Well, let's plug the donate. If people want to donate to help kind of upgrade the equipment, that'd be a start.
Yeah, because we're not trying to make money off this, but yeah.
No, not at all.
I definitely would use the money for equipment just to make their sound better. I think Godzilla would agree with that. Do you agree, Godzilla? Yeah. Maybe he'll be the first one to donate. He'll step on our studio.
And don't forget the show tomorrow night.
Oh, yeah.
It's at the same time as Brainwaves, though. So we're going to have some huge competition. They're doing a haunted house, I think. I might have to go to a cemetery and try to compete with them.
Let's just have our show. It'll be good.
Yeah. We're not trying to sound like Brainwaves. As one person told me, I was swearing on the air way before him.
Yeah, those guys are fun.
Yeah, they're awesome. Yeah,
I have to say, horror. I guess their main focus is like horror movies and stuff, and which is not something I watch. But when they're covering stuff other than exclusively horror, it's I like it.
Yeah, I do too. I like that one on like the Flat Earth Head one. But I had that planned way before they did that, because I know that this Flat Earth Head guy, that's what I wrote my song about, and I always had this plan that I was going to have him on, and that was a pretty good show, too. I'm going to have him on again.
It was painful to listen to. That sort of thing just pains me. Well.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, at least you listened to it. I was fascinated just with the psychology of the whole thing.
Yeah, it's kind of what I expected, actually. Although it did go way more disgustingly sexist than I thought it ever would.
Oh, the end of the show? Yeah, that was pretty bad.
On my show or on the on Brainwaves?
No, the Flat Earth show. Yeah.
Oh yeah, I have to listen back. I don't remember.
The Hey Marilyn end part.
Oh really? Yeah, was that on the same show? Yeah, what with Flat Earth Head? No, that was the next day. That was the next day.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm thinking more of the of George and his Hey Sweetie Honey stuff.
We tried. We try and fail more than we try and succeed, but things will turn around.
Well, I hear the music. That means we got 1 minute left. Good night, thanks, everybody.
Thanks, Wolfman.
And thank you guys for, and thank you, Amy. That was great.
And, you know, keep believing in stuff. Don't let a-holes like me get you down.
Oh, I see too much stuff. Well, you know, a lot of it, I'm very skeptical of myself. Like, first thing I do is, oh, no, that's got to be a plane. Or a Chinese lantern or something, you know. But then when I see it do things that just don't make sense, like, that's where I just kind of, I don't know, man. Okay.
Good night, folks.
Yeah. Good night, everybody.
Good night, a-hole.
Good night, a-hole.
Love it. Absolutely love it.